of the standard high-resolution MFL technology. And this is how it looks with the Ultra. So you see much more details which you don't see in the standard MFL. So how do we do that? I don't want to talk too much about the tools, but just to give you somehow an idea. The tool we have available in the market, which is commercially available, we have been running it even here in the region, also in Colombia. The standard MFL has a resolution of 4 to 6 millimeters. That's somehow comparable with UT. UT has a resolution of 4 millimeters as well. This tool has a resolution of 1.6 millimeters. So this is very close to the laser scan. A laser scan has a resolution of 1 by 1 millimeter. We can provide a resolution of 1 by 1.6 millimeter. So it's close to laser scan resolution. So of course, what I said already before, it will really give you a clear picture of your pipeline. It will in principle detect all the features present in your pipeline. And if you go back to the beginning of the presentation, where we had a very conservative approach in integrity assessment because we don't have a clear picture of the pipeline. Now with having this high resolution information, we can really give a much more reliable assessment, for example, in corrosion growth. So this is no one want to see in real. This is an example of a crack. So a crack is really complex. It's normally very small dimensions. It's combinations of pipe elements and anomalies. Similar shape can be critical or non-critical. So it's a very complex kind of features for us to be able to detect. So I think most of you are engineers, so you're available, you are aware of the principle of a crack and what can be possibly cause of a crack. So we can have either circumferential or axial cracks. Axial cracks are normally caused by the hoop stress, and examples of that are stress corrosion cracking, which is the most common kind of crack, fatigue crack, and also longitudinal weld cracks or undersea weld. On the other side, you have the circumferential cracks. That's caused by external loads or ground movements in the base material or in the weld. So in the introduction, I mentioned already that the UT tool was already developed in the 80s. I think the first crack detection tool was somewhere in the 90s. So why is this now so different, so new? First of all, there are different kind of crack detection tools. It depends on the medium in the pipeline. So in liquid lines, the UTCD, the UT crack detection tool, is the most common used tool. But this will not apply in gas lines, because for a UT tool, you need a liquid coupling, and normally you don't have that present in the gas line, and you also don't want to introduce liquid in your gas line if not necessary. So for this, there is the EMAT technology, which is electromagnetic acoustic transducer. And it actually creates the ultrasound wave in the pipe wall. So it doesn't need a coupling because it goes directly in the pipe wall. So the EMA tool has the same specifications as the UTCD, but it can be used in gas pipelines. So in principle, the whole area of liquid and gas pipelines is covered by these two technologies. So what are we doing? What are we doing different here? We're not talking about tools, but we're talking about a crack framework. So, like I said, crack is so complex that it doesn't really help to only provide you with the information of the crack. It doesn't help you in analyzing and make an assessment of the actual situation. So what we actually are doing is we start in the data gathering stage. So we'll ask you to provide us with as much possible information of your pipeline system, allowing us to make a first analysis of possible presence of cracks in your system. We can do that with susceptibility analysis, for example. So the outcome of this is we will select what kind of inline inspection would be the most suitable for your pipeline system. And then we actually follow the normal route of inline inspection. So we provide you with reports, field verification, pipeline repair if applicable, and that can go into your data management system. But we also can provide you with crack assessments. So based on the preliminary report, an immediate crack assessment. That means any critical crack present in your pipeline, we can report it immediately to you. And then the more details, complete crack assessment will be done at a later stage. We actually have simplified this. It's quite a complex framework. And we call it actually the hamburger approach. Yeah. So if you only have the hamburger, there's something missing. You're missing the bun, you're missing the letters. So for us, the hamburger is the inspection. The bun is the integrity. And then the lettuce and the cheese, the bacon, whatever you want, is the field verification. So you need the complete hamburger. Otherwise, it will not satisfy you. So we call it the hamburger approach. You can also call it the framework, crack framework. Okay, last but not least, I would like to talk to you about non-pickable pipelines. Actually, going back to 1965, we could inspect some pipelines, but a lot of pipelines were not inspectable. And then we saw with the development of the tools, with speed control, 1.5D capable, we could inspect more and more pipelines. But there are still a lot of pipelines which are not inspectable. And the industry called it non-pickable. That can depend on the length, diameter, pressure, flow, weld penetration, weld thickness change, especially if you are in a low pressure environment, that can result in very irregular running conditions of the tool, and the data is not useful as such. So, initially, those lines were not inspectable. So the only thing you can do is take UTG spot measurements to get at least an impression of the pipeline condition. But we don't like, first of all, we don't like the word unpickable. So for us, every pipeline is pickable. So we call it challenging, yeah? One pipeline can be more challenging than the other, but we don't like to call them unpickable because with the right effort, you can make a line pickable. So we call them challenging pipelines. So I can only give two examples given the time. So as you may or may not know, we're now talking about gas pipelines. We need a certain pressure in the pipeline to guarantee good run conditions for the inspection tool. So the smaller the diameter, the more pressure we need, because the cross-sectional area is smaller, so you need a higher pressure to have a certain force to make the tool traveling through the pipeline. So there is a certain regime for us to operate with the standard MFL tools. If we are getting below that, we have a so-called low-pressure kit. That means with small modifications to the tool, we can still operate in that range. If it's getting lower than that, we really have to go to a different concept. And that is what we call the low pressure tool. This is a 12-inch tool. I'm not sure whether you have seen inspection tools before, but normally a 12-inch tool would consist out of 3, 4, possible 5 segments. That means you need a segment for the batteries, you need segments for the storage, for the electronics. The more segments you have, the more polyurethane you need to carry the tool. And that everything in contact with the pipe hole will create drag and friction. And that is something you want to minimize because you are in a low pressure environment. So by applying this tool with a special polyurethane setup and have only one segment. So this segment is actually the magnet unit as well as the electronic. Everything is on board in one single module. So we are really able in having a very low friction and operating in a very low pressure environment. So then we go even lower, yeah? So even a low pressure tool is not applicable in this pressure regime. So the only thing you can do then is have a tool which is propel itself through the pipeline. So instead of making use of the medium, you have a mechanism on board of the tool which makes the tool traveling to the pipeline. And that is what we call the crawler. This one is bidirectional. That means it can travel forward and backwards. It has a camera on board, so we know exactly where the tool is, how far it has to go, and when it has to go back. It has the same high-resolution MFL technology as you saw on the other picture. It can go vertical, it can go horizontal, and it has a fail-safe mechanism because, of course, you run the tool in a very critical environment, very critical conditions, so something might happen to the tool. So in that case, the complete tool will collapse. So it is not in contact with the pipe wall anymore. And because it's tethered, we can just pull the tool back out of the pipeline. Either we can try to let it move backwards anyway, because it's bidirectional. If that's not possible, we always have that that tethered retrieval as a fail-safe mechanism. And I think by that, I finish my presentation. Thank you.
Hello. Hi. Thank you for the presentation. Just on the last one that you mentioned, that for the low pressure pipelines, that is self-propulsion. What is the mechanism of the propulsion for that tool?
It's kind of a tractor device. So it pulls itself through the pipeline.
Ah, so it's like a tractor.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.